Welcome, student, to the playlist of communication system. In this lecture, we are going to discuss few examples regarding PCM that we have discussed in our previous sessions. So, in order to have a more understanding, we are going to solve few examples regarding pulse code modulations. The example one, you can see a sinusoidal signal is transmitted using a PCM scheme. The target output SNR should be greater than 13 dB. Find the minimum number if representation level L and the minimum number of bits required to represent each sample to achieve the above performance, that is this 13 dB. So the first one, in this question, you're asked to calculate the minimum number of representation level. So SNR is given. So the SNR is 13 dB, and we know the simple equation of SNR. So SNR is equals to 1.8 plus 6N that we have solved in our previous session. So you can write directly 13 is equals to 1.8 plus 6N. And then you can rearrange 6N is equals to 13 minus 1.8, 6N is equals to 11.2. And then N is equals to 11.2 divided by 6, which is equals to 2 bit approximately. So we are taking the upper limit. And now the number of samples, we know L is equals to 2 raised to second thing, the number, the minimum number of bits required to represent each sample to the above performance, that is 2 bits, and the number of levels. For the number of levels, we know L is equal to 2 raised to power N, so which is equal to 2 raised to power 4, that is equals to 4. Now we are going to discuss a few more examples, that is about the PCM. So consider another example, that is consider a sinusoidal signal given by ST is equals to 3 sine 1000 pi t. So the signal is given. What you need to do, you need to find the output SNR when the signal is quantized using 9-bit PCM. The second question is find the minimum number of bits required to achieve the output SNR of at least 40 dB. Both condition is given. So the first one, you need to calculate the output SNR, and when the bit is given, you know, the bit is given, how many bits? 9. And we know the formula of SNR is equals to 6N plus 1.8. So here N is given. So N is 9, 9 6 is 54 plus 1.8. So which is equals to 55.8 dB. So that is the SNR, output SNR. The second question was that you need to find the minimum number of bits required to achieve the output SNR. So in this case, you need to achieve the output SNR at least 40 dB. And for that, how many minimum number of bits required? So again, we use the same formula, but in this case, we are inserting the value of SNR, which is 40 dB. So SNR is equals to 1.8 plus 6N. So SNR is given 40 dB, 1.8 plus 6N. And then you can write 6N is equals to 40 minus 1.8. And if you simplify it for N, so N is equals to 38.2 divided by 6, which is equals to 6.36. But the question was at least 40 dB, and we need to calculate the minimum number. So that is why we will select the upper value of this value, so which is equals to approximately 7 bit. You can insert the 7 bit, and you can select the 6 bit, and you can select the 7 bit and insert the value in this formula and see how much SNR you get. Let's suppose you are using 7 bit. So if you use 7 bit and then you insert in this formula, and then you can calculate what is the SNR. So 40 dB, so 6 multiplied by 7 plus 1.8, which is equals to 43.8 dB. So it means that you are under the limit, under the given limit that was at least 40 dB. So it means that you are in better condition, it is 43.8. But if you use lower value N6, so you can say that 40 dB is equals to 6 multiplied by 6 plus 1.8. So that is equals to 37.8. So this is, it means that you are lower from the at least condition. So you cannot satisfy the condition. So because you are ended up at 37.8 dB. So that is why we are usually selecting the upper limit, upper value. So that is 7 bit. Second question, a TV signal, and we know that a TV signal is usually a sine signal. So with a maximum frequency of 42 megahertz is transmitted using binary PCM. The number of quantization level is 1024. Two things are given. Signal is sine wave. Frequency or the bandwidth is given 42. Maximum frequency means that is bandwidth. So that is 42 megahertz. And the quantization level L is given, that is 1024. What you need to calculate, code word length N. So it means that you can use this formula L. L is equal to 2 raised to the power N. Or you can say N is equal to log 2 L. So log 2 L, N is equal to log 2 1024. So if you take the log of that value, you will end up with 10 bits. The second question was transmission bandwidth. You need to calculate transmission bandwidth. So we know the bandwidth. The bandwidth was given, that is 42 megahertz. For each sample, we have 10 bits. And what is the actual bandwidth is equal to the number of bits multiplied by the message bandwidth. So if you take insert N, so N you have calculated here, that is 10. And this is also given, that is 42 megahertz. So it means that the actual bandwidth is equal to 420 megahertz. Third question was average output SNR. So this is sine wave, and we know that this formula for the sine wave of SNR is equal to 1.8 plus 6N. So if you insert the value of N, we already calculate, that is 10 bit. So if you insert 10 bits, so 60 plus 1.8, the answer is 16.8 dB. Fourth, you need to calculate bit rate. So bit rate, for in order to calculate the bit rate, you need to know the sampling rate, because the formula for the bit rate is equal to sampling rate multiplied by the number of samples. So that is why you need to know what is sampling rate. So we know that the sampling rate is twice the bandwidth. So if you 2 multiplied by W, so that is equal to 84. So you can write 84 here. So N is the number of, you can say N is the number of samples. So bit per samples and sample per second. So sample cancels. The remaining is bit per second. So that is bit rate. So if you insert N is 10, FS is 84. So it is 840 megabit per second. I hope you understand these examples. We are trying to get some more example in our next session. And we are closing this session. And keep in contact with our next session so that you can have more example in our next lecture. Thank you for watching the video.